I was 7 years old when I first saw an image of the Earth from space. And the big round shape and the white clouds, the huge blue ocean were so beautiful to me. It was that experience that led me to search for the secrets of the planets. I was a graduate student at the University of Arizona's Lunar and Planetary Laboratory when we got the first pictures back from Saturn's largest moon, Titan. Everything we knew about Titan up to that point told us that there was no way there could be sand dunes on the surface. So when the first pictures came down, we all gathered around the computer to look. And to our surprise, the equator was entirely covered in seas of sand. This sand is one of the missing pieces for understanding how organic matter on Titan interacts between the atmosphere and the landscape. Organic matter we know is critical for the existence of life. So if we can know how these organic sands form on Titan, we can better understand if the conditions there are right for life. Only there's a problem. Titan is 800 million miles away from the Earth at its closest point. So that's not exactly easy for us to be able to go and collect data in person. By studying the dunes and the sands of Earth, we can actually compare those with Titan and better understand how dunes are formed. So we've traveled the world over, analyzing these extraordinary dune formations. As we've researched the sand, we've come to understand what properties the sand needs to be able to form dunes. First of all, it needs to be sand-sized, small enough to be picked up by the wind, big enough to be dropped again. Then it also needs to be round and hard, not broken down easily. And that tells us that the methane in Titan's atmosphere, which breaks up by sunlight, must combine into longer carbon chains. These then clump together up in the atmosphere, they gently snow down to the surface, and they make an organic bedrock. This then erodes to produce sand. This suggests that organic matter is not just in the sand, but it permeates the entire atmosphere of Titan. There also needs to be wind present to shape the dunes, and this separates and isolates them. We saw that in pictures of dunes across Titan, as individual stripes of dark and light across the surface. This tells us that the atmosphere of Titan must be dynamic, like Earth's. Unfortunately, there's only so much we can learn about Titan by studying our own home planet. But once the Dragonfly mission arrives in 2034, we'll be able to start to put the puzzle pieces together. Dragonfly is unlike any other mission we've launched. We've had orbiters and landers and rovers. Most of those can only travel a few miles across the surface in weeks or even months. But Dragonfly will travel hundreds of miles across the surface of Titan. Its focus is the sand dunes. It will land there, it will pick up material, and will be able to tell us exactly what it's made of. With just a little bit of sand, you can hold the history of an entire region in the palm of your hand, all encased in those tiny grains. I do that every time I go out into the field. I pick up the sand and I look at it. I ask, what are the colors and the shapes and the sizes? Where did it come from? What sorts of secrets am I sifting through my fingers? We've been studying the sand on Earth one handful at a time, but once our mission lands, we can do that on Titan too. And then Dragonfly will get me my handful of sand. Though Titan's dunes are still a mystery, with every grain of sand we find and see and study, we're one step closer to uncovering the secrets of the sands of Titan. And that is beautiful to me.